Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about the various tracking radar modes which are used by the tracking radar. So let's begin with the topic. The term radar is basically stands for radio detection and ranging equipment. The radar was invented originally in World War II by the military in order to detect the position of enemy and in order to detect the location of enemy. So radar at that time was used as an electronic eye and fulfilled the requirement of the military application. But after that, the radar finds its application in many areas, like it is used in the remote sensing application for weather prediction, weather broadcasting and weather observation. It is also used on the highways for measuring the speed of the vehicles. It is also used for law enforcement purpose. It is used in oil and air exploration system and many more applications. So in this way, the radar finds its application in many communication systems. So in this topic, basically we are going to cover what do you mean by tracking radar and what are the different modes of the tracking radar. So let's first talk about what do you mean by tracking radar. Basically, the tracking radar provides coordinates of the target and provides the data that can be used to detect the position of the target. Or we can use the same data for predicting the position of target in future. The tracking radar first searches the object and then provides its coordinate in order to detect its position. The same data can be used for the future for predicting its future position. Now let's move on to the various modes of the tracking radar. So the first mode of radar is single target track. In single target track, there is only one object. That means the radar is used to search only one object. It continuously scans the position of one object only and it ignores all other objects. In case of single track radar, the rate at which the target samples is equal to the pulse repetition frequency. Basically, the pulse repetition frequency is nothing but the maximum number of pulses which are present at the output, and it provides the range, that is ambiguous range, for range as well as for Doppler shift. The next type of radar is nothing but the spotlight track. Now in the case of spotlight track, the radar first scan or radar first track first object and tracks that object continuously for a particular period of time. After tracking first object for a particular period of time, radar moves to the next object and it also tracks it for a certain amount of time. Therefore, likewise, it continues with the other types of object present in the system. So, for every radar, there is a particular amount of time is allocated for each object. And after completing the last object, the radar comes back to first object and repeat the same cycle of operation. So, such type of tracking is called as spotlight tracking. But the spotlight tracking provides less accurate data related to the position and location of the radar as compared to the single track radar. Because it may possible that while scanning or tracking one object, the other object may change its position. And because of that, the accurate position of the object cannot be detected by the radar system. So this is one of the considered as disadvantage of spotlight tracking. Now let's move on to the next type of radar tracking, and that is nothing but multi-target track. Now in case of multi-target track, a single radar system is used to track the several objects per cycle. And therefore, the single radar performs function of multiple radars. Now, for such type of tracking, it is very much important to use the changeable antenna beam. And this type of changeable antenna beam is achieved by using the electronically scanned antennas. So, multiple radar system or multiple scanning or multiple tracking provides information related to one or more than one targets which are present in the space. Let's move on to the next type of tracking, that is nothing but track while scan. In this type of tracking, the radar scans several targets per scan and it tracks the position of several targets per scan. At the same time, it uses some sophisticated smoothing algorithm in order to detect the position or location of the target. Therefore, it is called as track while scan. In this type of tracking, we can say it is not actually the tracking or scanning of the object, because in this type of tracking, the sampling rate is very, very smaller than the Nyquist rate. Because of this, it cannot come under the category of scanning and tracking. In addition to these type of tracking, the two more types of tracking present in the tracking radar system, and that is nothing but acquisition and tracking. In acquisition mode, a specific location or the specific direction is given to the antenna beam in order to track or in order to detect the position of the object. The designated location or the designated source may be a single scan method which provides information related to azimuth angle and range, 2D scan tracking which provides information about the azimuth angle and range, 3D scan method which provides information only about the range of the system, optical scan method, then manual control of scanning. So these are nothing but the various types of method that can be used for providing the designated source information. Now let's move on to the block diagram of the tracking system. Now figure shows the block diagram of automatic tracking system. In automatic tracking system, the information is collected with the help of tracking antennas, then receiver, and the timing and triggering circuit. In this type of block diagram, the time delay and velocity information is also provided by using the timing circuit. Now here the duplexer is used, which is used for performing the function of antenna as both. That means the antenna can be used as a transmitting antenna or it can be used as a receiving antenna. So duplexer allows the antenna to use for transmission and reception purpose. Because of this, there is no need for using two separate antenna for transmission and reception purpose. When the antenna is controlled by a transmitter, then it is used as a transmitting antenna and performs the function of transmission. Whereas when it is controlled by the receiver, then it is called as receiving antenna and it performs the function of receiving echo signal from the target. Now in case of automatic scanning or in case of automatic tracking system, the angular error must be provided by one target at a time. If one or more than one target provides the angular error at the same time or angular velocity at the same time, then it is not possible to detect the exact location or position of the target. So this is what about the block diagram of automatic tracking system. Now in this case, the getting pulse is generated with the help of range or Doppler gate generator circuit. And with the help of azimuth and elevation angle, we can determine the exact location or range of the target. That means the maximum distance up to which the radar system can detect the object. So this is what about the various tracking modes that can be used in the tracking radar system. So now let's move on to the MCQs. Before moving to MCQs, let's have a look of the waveform which is used for describing the generation of the getting pulse. Here the ungated signal is given and when the track gate signal is applied, at that time the gated signal is get generated. Now let's look at the question number 1. And the question is, find out the odd option from the following list. And the list is single tracking track, monopulse track, spotlight track, multi-target track. Basically, in this topic, we are talking about the various modes of the tracking radar. And we know that the various modes of the tracking radar includes the option number A, that is single track, option number C, that is spotlight track, and option number D, that is multi-target track. So here, the odd term is nothing but monopulse track. So we can say the option B is nothing but the answer of the question. Now let's move to the next question. And the question is, the term getting refers to option A is scanning multiple targets at a time, option B is ranging signal acquired target, option C is selecting single target and rejects other target, and option D is pulse shaping. So we can say the selecting multiple targets at a time is considered as the right answer. So this is what about the topic of different tracking modes used by the tracking radar, which includes single tracking method, which includes multiple tracking methods, then continuous wave scanning and multiple target tracking. So this is what about the various methods which are included in tracking radar for tracking the various objects which are moving or stationary in the nature. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.